States, but it's all over. We're seeing great corporations that in a short period of years no longer exist. They're brilliant. But she didn't talk about the Bronze Age, so I thought I would add to that.
Horizontal teaching is higher than any other European country, and generalized trust is low. Teaching the skills that are important. And of course, we ought to think about teaching.
Please, thank you. Welcome, Commissioner. We have Commissioner Corina Cretu, who is responsible for regional policy.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kalispera. Thank you very much for the invitation to speak to this Delphi Economic Forum. I just came 1 hour ago, and to be honest, I am astonished by the beauty of this region. I thought that I know Greece, but really I would like to congratulate you for choosing this place for us. And I had this chance to hear some very interesting interventions. Of course, one of the most frequent words was, unfortunately, the world crisis. And of course, it is very important that we are here and we talk about underinvestment crisis, which is really a serious underinvestment crisis. And of course, compared to the historical trend, the estimation of the European Commission is that the European economy is now missing more than 300 billion euro in investment. So our aim is to address, as European Commission, this issue. On Monday, for instance, together with Vice President Katainen, we issued a guidance to not join investments involving the Juncker's plan, the European Fund for Strategic Investments, with structural funds. And I think it's a very important tool at the EU level to join forces, to combine all and use all the tools in order to address this underinvestment crisis. The investment gap is spread, as you have seen here, across all the EU, but in some southern member states, total investments fell from 30% to 50% since the beginning of the crisis. And today, public investment is around 15% lower than before the crisis. So as a result, the GDP has dramatically fallen, seriously undermining convergence across EU regions. So some of the regions lost two decades of convergence. Second consequences, you know very well that we have what we say, another state, 22 million people, or 10% of the working population is unemployed. So like one European, big European country. Here again, this crisis has particular hit the southern countries where 80% of job losses are concentrated. Of course, we talked here about the risk of poverty and social exclusion, which concerns today one European in four, or 122 million people. So you can agree with me that, of course, we would like to be optimistic, but the situation is not sustainable economically, socially, and also politically. So we need to set those regions on a new, more robust growth path. From our point of view, for the Commission, the way ahead lies in a triangle involving sound fiscal and macroeconomic policies with an ambitious structural reforms agenda and also effective public investment programs. So the first side is fiscal responsibility. We need to make sure that public finances remain under control. Concerning structural reforms, our experience shows that investments simply don't work unless the right conditions for investments are in place. We launched now in our DG Regio a study, for instance, to see the impact of European funds, because we have regions like, to say, I'll not tell Greece, I'll say Mezzogiorno in Italy, for instance, where we really pumped money for so many years, and we don't see really some results in terms of growth and jobs. And in other regions, of course, the investments of European funds, they have a really very, very great impact. So I think money is not enough. We have to have efficient public administration, effective public procurement, easy and reliable access to finance for small businesses, to name just a few things. I think it's very important to establish all the conditions in place to get the most from our public investments. And of course, an ambitious public investment program. In this policy, regional policy, I think it's playing a major role. For instance, in Greece, 85% 2 years ago of public investment, all public investments were done with European money. We have 450 billion euro available until 2020 from the European Structural and Investment Funds. And I think we have to mobilize all means that we have. I have referred earlier at what we call the Juncker Plan, Juncker's investment plan, but we as regional policy as well, we join forces with other EU funds, policies and priorities. I'm thinking to the Energy Union, the Digital Single Market, as well to the Union's major support to research, which is a program Horizon 2020. So I think it's very important to have committed and well-informed stakeholders ready to give their best for their projects and for their communities. I think it's utmost importance that investment policies involve stakeholders from the very outset. I say that because now we are in the beginning of programming period, 2014-2020. I was yesterday to the Ministry of Economy and today in the Parliament, and I made very clear that it's very important not to have delays. My visit here is to show the solidarity of European Union with Greece. So, but I really think that it's very important to show the Commission commitment to support the Greek people in this difficult situation. But of course, it's a shared responsibility. We made already the commitment to support every effort to get the country out of the economic crisis and bring it back to a growth path. To be honest, we left no stone unturned to help Greece to make full use of the funds for the 2007-2013 period. It was not easy for me last year to go in the European Parliament and fight for changing the regulation in extraordinary conditions. We changed the regulations for Greece. We offered extraordinary 100% co-financing measures, which is cannot call anymore co-financing, flexibility to address the delays, and expert advice for capacity building in order to deliver quality projects. So that I said yesterday also to the ministry, and last year all the time we did whatever it took. So with 100% co-financing, in the last 3 months we disbursed to Greece almost 3 billion euro, 2 billion euro, and now in the beginning of the programming period. So there is not any excuse not to go on and deblock the major projects of Greece, which are the extension of metro line in Athens, the metro line in Thessaloniki, the waste management projects which are in very big crisis, especially in Attica and Peloponnese, and motorways concessions. I think it's very important to pass this message that from our side, we did whatever it takes. This is the only country I came 3 times in a year, so I think it's very important to keep these commitments for the new programming period 2014-2020. And I would like also to change the tone and say that we are optimistic in a sense that I think partnership agreement for Greece lives up to our ambitions for the country, and it offers a financial framework for investment or of more than 20 billion euro in the next year. But as I said, it's very important to start in time with in time these projects. So as I said, we made also an extraordinary pre-financing for Greece with 1 billion euro in the beginning of this program, programming period. Usually, European Commission release only 1% of the money as a pre-financing, but we made this exception for Greece, and we released in the first year 7% of the total 20 billion euros. So, in order to help a bit with the liquidity problems that Greece was facing. So in total, as I said, thanks to the extraordinary measures the Commission proposed and the European Parliament together with the Council approved, more than 2 billion euros were paid in the last 3 months in Greece. And above all, the strategic plan agreed in partnership agreement lays down the foundation of a new economic model based on innovation and competitiveness. And also we have these ongoing discussions with authorities to invest more in small and medium-sized enterprises. And I was very happy yesterday to hear from the minister that they will adopt the SMEs initiative, which is, I think, is very important. So I'm very confident that we can help. We are very much aware of the huge burden that Greece is facing, facing last year with the crisis, now with the refugee crisis. So anyhow, I would like to assure that on the side of European Commission, we support structural reforms. We support these investments because they are engines of growth of tomorrow. But we have some thematic objectives: innovation, competitiveness, smart infrastructures, smart cities. I am very glad that all these funds are available now for Greece. But as I said in the beginning, it is up to us now to use them for the benefit of Greek citizens. And we say us, it's of course, it's, as I said, shared responsibility. So I think nobody can replace the patience and sustained work of projects promoters on the ground. And also when I said about Juncker's plan, I was asked today by Alpha Television why Greece did not benefit for this plan until now. And I said that it was not any project submitted. So we cannot design projects from Brussels. So it's up to stakeholders here to... We have also this advisory hub in order to help to design projects, but in the end, it's up to the member states to design good projects. So let me take this occasion to encourage the Greek authorities to build on their long experience in managing EU funds, to stand by project promoters and support their day-to-day efforts, because since the accession of Greece in the European Union, from 81, you have a long-standing experience, good and bad, but I think it's very important. When I first came as a commissioner, I was astonished I was very surprised to see in the Greek television these debates about Brexit, because when we see the figures, 85% of all public investments, where would have been Greece without this money, without these thousands of schools done by European Union? I made 5 regions with 1,000 kilometers, and it was not 1 kilometer which was not done with European money. And the bridge Rio anti Rio, and also the metro in Athens. And I gave an interview, and the journalist told me, I've heard that the metro in Athens was done with some European money. And I said, it was not some European money. It was 95% of the metro in Athens were done with European money. So, of course, I think it's very important to show and to praise the efforts of Greece, but also we are now at this crisis and everybody is saying that Europe is bad, Europe is impossible, is bureaucracy. We talk about Brexit, but this is because we were shy away to talk about what we are doing as European Commission. So I think it's very important. Of course, my policy is very criticized because it became very complex, and this is true. But in the same time, it was European Parliament and European Council who voted these regulations. And in the same time, we have projects that they need 20, 30 signatures, and this is not a requirement by the European Commission. It's just the national legislation. So we are working now to see how to simplify. But in the same time, of course, we have on the one hand, the need to simplify, because I don't want to see any more small and medium-sized enterprises giving up to access our funds because the process is too complicated, too bureaucratic, but in the same time as European money, they have to be controlled, and I think it's very important to have a balance between simplification and control. So my message is that European Commission and myself personally will stand by you in all this endeavor in these difficult times. And of course, I wish you good luck, Efcaristopoli, and all the best.
Thank you very much, Commissioner. We have 5-minute break.